I am not a scholar of English or literature. I am a writer, and by that definition, I am someone who has always loved language. I am fascinated by language in daily life. I spend a great deal of my time thinking about the power of language, the way it can evoke an emotion, a visual image, a complex idea, or a simple truth. Language is a tool of my trade, and I use them all the Englishes I grew up with. Recently, I was made keenly aware of the different Englishes I do use. I was giving a talk to a large group of people, the same talk I had already given to half a dozen other groups. The talk was about my writing, my life, and my book, The Joy Luck Club, and it was going along well enough until I remembered one major difference that made the whole talk sound wrong. My mother was in the room, and it was perhaps the first time she had heard me give a lengthy speech, using the kind of English I had never used with her. The English I used with her was different. Just last week, I found myself conscious of the English I was using. I noticed myself using the phrase, "not waste money that way." This is a scenario that played in my head.
So, the couch that we saw at IKEA the other day,
no, too expensive, but no waste money that way. People throw their couches all the time in the driveway. Just pick one up, free.
The language I grew up with was a different sort of English that relates to family talk. To give you some idea of what this family talk sounds like, I videotaped my mother during a conversation we had.
So, du zhong having business, like fruit stand, off the street kind. He's du zhong like, he's du like in du zhong, but that's the Sunming Island people. The local people call Pu Tong. And they're on the river east side, so he belonged to that local people. The man wanted to ask the Duzong father to take him in to become like own family, but the Duzong father wasn't looking down on him, but didn't take them seriously either la. Until that man become a mafia, or he could kill people. Oh my goodness. Now he's a very important person, very hard to invite him. The Chinese way only come to show respect, but don't stay for dinner. Respect for making big celebration, he show up. But won't stay too long. He came to my wedding. I didn't see it, but I heard it. People said he was there.
My mother has long realized the limitations of her English as well. When I was a teenager, she used to have me call people on the phone and pretend I was she. In this guise, I was forced to ask for information or even complain and yell at people who had been rude to her. One time, it was a call to her stockbroker in New York.
Oh my god, Da. This music's so awful. Oh, I have to complain about this music too. Oh, it hurt my ear. Oh. Should I complain to them about the music?
It's okay.
I think that they're very bad. Bad customer service.
Hello, this is Mrs. Tan.
Why doesn't he send me check already 2 weeks late? So mad he lied to me, losing me money.
Hi, Mrs. Tan. How may I help you?
I'm getting rather concerned. You agreed to send me the check 2 weeks ago, but it still hasn't arrived.
I understand your concern. I will attend to your circumstance as soon as possible.
What he want? I come to New York, tell him in front of his boss, you cheating on me? Oh, you don't cheat
I can't tolerate any more excuses. If I don't receive the check immediately, I'm going to have to speak to your manager when I'm in New York next week.
Oh, he did very bad at his job. How did he get that job anyway? Oh, I could talk to his manager about that too.
1 week later.
Hi, how may I help you?
Are you the manager here?
Yes.
Okay, I'll talk to you later.
So
you know what you're doing then, right?
Can you elaborate a little bit?
So like other day I talked to a very bad employer of yours. And like, I asked my money, but he don't give me my money. So where my money?
Many hours later.
You know what? Oh my gosh. In the future, I just go to other places. There's so much more people better than you. You know, you don't do your job properly. Your employee doesn't do your job properly.
We had a similar routine more recently for a situation that was more serious.
A couple weeks ago, I got the CAT scan, and I was wondering what the result are.
Okay, give me 1 moment, I'll check.
Are you still checking? Okay.
I'm so sorry. It seems as if the CAT scan images were lost. I'm sorry, but there's nothing else I can do.
Lost? What do you mean lost? What? So I don't know my result? You don't know my result either? But my husband, my son, they died from the brain tumor. What if I die too?
I'm sorry to hear that, but I can't give you any more information at this time. You have to make another appointment for another scan.
What? I'm not leaving until you call my daughter.
Hello, is this Miss Tam?
Yes, this is she.
Your mother is in our office. We lost the CAT scan that she took a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, they did.
She insisted I call you regarding her missing scan.
Oh, really? Are you sure there's nothing that can be done to help with the CAT scan?
Well, let me see.
What are you trying to see? Oh, your calendar. Oh, you're not a very busy doctor. Are you new?
I'll hold a conference call on Monday. I assure you that it'll be found. I apologize for the most regrettable mistake and the suffering of your mother.
So you can do something right.
I think my mother's English almost had an effect on limiting my possibilities in life as well. Sociologists and linguists probably will tell you that a person's developing language skills are more influenced by peers and by family. But I do think that the language spoken in the family, especially in immigrant families, plays a large role in shaping the language of the child. And I believe that affected my results on achievement tests, IQ tests, and the SAT. While my English skills were never judged poor, compared to math, English could not be considered my strong suit. This was understandable. Math is precise. There's only one correct answer. Whereas for me, at least, the answers on English tests were always a judgment call, a matter of opinion, and personal experience.
So easy to read.